Welcome back to another session in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, I want you to get the best out of Adobe Premiere, and one of the areas which can be really overwhelming is the export settings. So I'm going to show you the best export settings for YouTube videos to make the whole process less scary and much easier. So let's see how it's done.
Okay, so we have an edit together and we want to export. But before we jump in, it is important to take note of what is highlighted in your interface. You'll notice that if you have another window selected, which you can see indicated by these blue borders around the panels, and if we try to render the video, we don't even have the option. It's grayed out or just won't work. So make sure that you have your timeline sequence selected. Now, there are two ways that we can export the video: the long way or the smart way. To do it the long way, we need to go up to File, scroll down this list, and go to Export Media and click that.
Now, I know it doesn't sound like that much work, but trust me, going through all of those menus all of the time, all of those seconds can really add up into minutes, and then over the year, that's hours. And remember, when you're editing, time is money.
The smart way is to do it instantly. All we need to do is hit Command plus M if you're on a Mac, or Control plus M if you're on a PC. Okay, so this is your export window, and it might look a little bit scary, but don't worry, we're going to show you how to use a preset so it does most of the work for you. Over here, we have our file format, and as you can see, there are a lot of options. We're only interested in using the H.264 format since it's a nice small file format and keeps a lot of the video quality. So select that. Underneath, you have this preset drop-down menu, which has a bunch of options that will automatically adjust most of your settings to what you need. If you scroll down the list, you can see we have YouTube 1080p and YouTube 4K. In our example, we're just using 1080p, but if you're using 4K, then just select that.
Now, this preset gets us 90% of the way there. See, not so scary.
Now, you want to give your video a name and a destination for it to export to. So click on this blue file name and give it any name you want, and then select a folder where you want to save it and click Save. You want to tick this Render at Maximum Depth checkbox to ensure you get the best quality possible from your video. In the bitrate settings, you have three options: CBR, VBR 1-pass, and VBR 2-pass. CBR will give you the highest possible quality, but we wouldn't recommend that. It makes your file size absolutely huge and will take a very long time to upload to YouTube. For our videos, we're using VBR 2-pass, which is just a clever setting that retains the quality for your video and keeps your file size fairly small, making it much faster to upload to YouTube. Now you have these two sliders show up underneath. You'll want to change these depending on the resolution you're exporting in. Now, there's something to bear in mind here. YouTube is going to compress the video quality, and we will get a little loss in some of the detail. So for 1080p video, we're going to input a value of 30 in the minimum and 40 in the maximum. If you're using 4K, you may want to set the minimum to around 40 and the maximum to around 60.
This is actually much higher than we need for YouTube, but I always think it's a top tip to export in a higher quality than you need for YouTube, because YouTube actually adds some compression and it can remove some of the quality from your video. So if you export in a higher quality, you retain some of that quality that you're going to lose along the way.
There's no guarantee that this makes a big difference, but it's better to be on the safe side. Now all that's out of the way, all we have to do is check Use Maximum Render Quality. You can go and tweak your audio settings up in this tab if you want to, but our YouTube preset does the work for us, so you can leave this at the default. We just wanted you to know that there is a window to tweak the audio should you need to. But everything is fine, and now we can just hit Export. And that's it.
So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope it's really helping you in Adobe Premiere. Remember, if you want to see more videos like this, you can find us on YouTube on our Editor's Keys channel. And we're also on Facebook as well, /Editor's Keys. So check us out, and we hope to see you again very soon.